Hey guys, today we're taking a look at my Benkei OTK deck. Now this deck is very silly, very fun. Not sure if it's too competitive, but can be interesting to play. So basically the idea is that you use cards like Benkei, and you use a ton of equip cards to really overload your opponent, do some extremely powerful plays. So Benkei, obviously the star of the deck, so for every equip card he gets, he can attack again. So when you get more equip cards, you can give him, you know, a ton of attacks on top of high attack, and yeah, you can destroy your opponent very quickly. We also have Mahavilo. So Mahavilo is kind of an alternative to Benkei. He just gains attack for equip cards, so he's just a real powerhouse, stronger than Benkei, but doesn't get those additional attacks, but still very useful. And then we have Battle Fader, very good in this deck, allowing you to defend for a little bit. Can be nice on top of United We Stand, but yeah, just very useful. Card Karti, also very, very good, giving you some draw power. You need a lot of cards in your hand to make this deck work, so you really need to have some draw power. And you have cards like Battle Fader, and you don't really mind taking some damage to set up what you need to do. Then the spell cards, United We Stand, very powerful. Mage Power, very, very powerful in this deck with all the spell cards you have. Shooting Star Bow Seal, allowing you to attack directly, very, very powerful. Definitely debated putting three in this deck just because getting more than one is not that great. But, you know, with how powerful these cards work and how Benkei works, gaining attacks is still not that bad. Hidden Armory, very good for this deck, getting out whatever equip spell you need for the certain time. Again, you have cards like Battle Fader to protect yourself, you know, in case you, you know, won't be able to do anything. Then we have Axe of Despair, just for the 1,000 attack boost. You can tribute a monster to get it back, so you can tribute, you know, Battle Fader, which is an interesting choice. Pot of Duality, obviously not doing very much special summoning in this deck. You're only really special summoning Battle Fader, and that's not during your turn, so good for getting what you need. Upstart Goblin to thin the deck a bit. And then Release Restraint Wave, debated running more of this. Basically just Heavy Storm for your opponent's set cards. Can be very, very useful, but losing an equip card can be kind of annoying because of how this deck works. Still very useful, like I said. And then Gold Sarcophagus to search out what you need, usually Benkei. Reinforcement of the Army also to search out Benkei. And then we have Reckless Greed. Again, getting all those cards in your hand right away is very important. And Trap Stun, the real, the only way we can really deal with back row. You can also run like MST or something like that, but currently doing Trap Stun. One of the other choices would have been Forbidden Lance. Forbidden Lance would be awesome for this deck if it wasn't for the fact that it'll negate, you know, all the equip cards that are on your monster, so it really doesn't help you very much. So now for the extra deck, not really much to say here. Honestly, you shouldn't use the extra deck at all in this deck. It's pretty much pointless, but I do have some cards in here just in case. Slacker Magician for two Battle Faders in case you need, you know, to stall. Doolahan, also useful. And then a bunch of 4-stars, you know, like Blade Armor Ninja if you have two Benkeis, Digusto for draw power, a bunch of different things, Crazy Box to stall, Utopia to stall, but it's really not what you're trying to do in this deck. These are just, you know, things that you can do in case, you know, in extreme emergencies. So now for the side deck. Again, side decks in my videos are kind of just recommended cards that can also work with the deck when you're building it yourself. It isn't a side deck for matches. These are cards you might just want to consider when you're starting to look at this deck type. So Big Eye, the original one, can actually be really useful to set up what you're going to get, because you need very specific cards to make this deck work. Swift Scarecrow, also really good. It has pros, you know, over Battle Fader, but Battle Fader is nice, so you can get, you know, a boost from United We Stand, so it's up to you. Farid can search out Benkei, which is really nice. Elemental Hero Wildheart, another way to get through back row if you use a card like this and focus on equip cards, can be really nice. Guildford the Legend, a very interesting card that allows you to stack your monsters on the field with equip cards, which is very, very interesting, but currently not what I'm trying to do. Iron Blacksmith Kotetsu, just to search out an equip card. Magical Merchant, two search out spells, but not really a big fan of this for this deck type, honestly. The Warrior Returning Alive can get Benkei back. MST, like I said, another way of dealing with back row. Mistbody, good for stalling, you know, for Benkei or something. You could just put this out and equip him, you know, have him already have an equip card, but still stall until you get as many as you need. Big Bang Shot can be very useful for owning your opponent's, you know, defense monster, but if you lose this, you're going to lose your monster, so it's definitely a bit risky. Dark Door can be really good for this deck because you're usually only attacking with one monster at once. Messenger of Peace, really, really good for this deck. Definitely debated putting this in this deck, but just currently didn't work out for me. Royal Decree, another card that you can run instead of Trap Stun. And Blast with Chain, you know, there's other traps that are also equipped cards, can also be useful for this deck type, but just, you know, not currently what I'm focusing on. Focusing more on that pure attack boost from the Magic cards. So that's my Ben K deck. Again, very fun to play, very silly. You'd be surprised how fast it can just overwhelm your opponent. And if you have the right hand, there's not that many things they can do about it. The biggest issue with this deck is that if they negate your effects, you are going to lose. That's pretty much it. But otherwise, it definitely has some very powerful things it can do. But if you guys have your own Ben K decks, you know, post below, let me know in the comments, talk about what cards you use. You can make suggestions for me and that kind of thing. But thank you guys for watching. I'll see you later.